Good afternoon, everyone. Could I have your attention, please? Thank you. Good afternoon. Welcome to Newcastle University for this congregation ceremony. I'd just like to spend a few minutes explaining this afternoon's proceedings. The ceremony will begin shortly and should last for about 45 minutes. When the ceremony is about to start, the academic procession will enter the hall from the rear doors led by a Northumbrian piper. At that point, I will ask you to stand and to remain standing until the procession have taken their seats on the stage. The presiding officer for this ceremony is one of our Pro-Vice Chancellors, Professor Stephanie Glendenning. Professor Glendenning will open the ceremony and will give a short welcome speech. Graduates, firstly, congratulations. You've worked very hard in order to be here today, and we want to make sure that you receive the correct qualification and have the correct name read out as you cross the stage. Therefore, can I ask you to check one last time that your ticket number matches your seat number? Because if it doesn't, you will find that your name will have changed as you cross the stage. When a ceremony begins, each row of graduates will be asked by the marshals to stand one row at a time, starting from the back. You'll be directed by the marshals to process down the side of the hall and up onto the stage. It is tradition at Newcastle for graduates to be hooded ceremoniously on the stage. If you wish to be hooded as part of the ceremony, your hood should now be neatly folded over your right arm. When you get to the stage, there's an X marked on the stage. If you just stand on the X, face the presiding officer in the center of the stage. The hooding marshal, who will be standing to your right, will take the hood from over your right arm and place it over your head. She doesn't need any help with this. She's done it many times before. Once you hear your name read out, cross the stage and shake hands with the presiding officer. Then you leave the stage in the center and you walk back down the center aisle, and a marshal will direct you back to your seat. Please remember to smile when you cross the stage, as there's a photographer up in the balcony there who will be taking your photographs, which will be available to purchase after the ceremony. If you do not wish to shake hands with the presiding officer, that's fine. All we ask you to do is to hold a copy of your congregation's brochure in your hand as you cross the stage, which will indicate to the presiding officer to acknowledge you in a different way. Please note that although this ceremony represents a chance to celebrate your achievements, it's also a formal and traditional event. We would therefore like to politely request that you do not take any selfies or make any recordings whilst enjoying your moment on stage. Guests, at Newcastle, we like to make sure every graduate has their moment of glory on stage. They've deserved it. Please applaud everyone. Not all graduates are lucky enough to have family and friends here today, but please try and pace yourselves and save a little energy for the end, as we have, I think, 134 graduates crossing the stage today, and they all deserve your applause. After all the graduates have crossed the stage, there will be a short speech by one of today's graduates. The ceremony will then be closed by our registrar, who will ask guests and graduates to stand while the academic procession leaves the hall. Immediately after the ceremony, all guests and graduates are invited to a reception, which will be held in the Lindisfarne Room in the Hadrian Building. Finally, some polite requests and reminders. Please switch off your mobile phones and any other devices that may disturb the ceremony, or at least have them on silent mode. You're welcome to use your camera, but please do not obstruct the view of other guests, and please don't approach the stage. In the event of a fire alarm or emergency evacuation, please remain calm and the marshals will quickly guide you out of the nearest exit and out of the building. And graduates, please remember to return your gowns and hoods to the robe makers before you leave at the end of the day. We hope you enjoy the ceremony and have a wonderful day here in Newcastle. Thank you. Thank you. please stand?
I hereby declare this congregation open, which is held for the conferment of university awards. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Professor Stephanie Glendinning, and I am the Pro Vice Chancellor for the Faculty of Science and Engineering. And it is my great privilege to welcome you to this graduation ceremony here in the wonderful surroundings of the King's Hall for the conferring of degrees for our School of Computing. For us, graduation ceremonies are really the highlights of our academic year. They are exciting and colourful occasions when you earn the right to proudly wear the robes which symbolise the award of your academic qualifications and celebrate your fantastic achievements with your family, friends, and tutors. I remember my first graduation ceremony very clearly, and I remember the excitement we all felt standing at the gateway of our new lives with an overriding feeling of we made it and a great sense of possibility. A few years later, I graduated with my PhD. I had a young daughter that I believe might resonate with one of our graduates here today. And the PhD was really giving me an opportunity to step into a new career in academia. I felt that I had overcome some personal challenges to reach that point. And so the sense of achievement then was much more personal. Whatever the degree you are being awarded today, you will have travelled a far rockier road than I had to take. A pandemic took so much away from your university experience, the experience that you had once imagined. And the world that you graduate into is in such a state of change. The world I first graduated into was about to experience financial turmoil and huge fluctuations in interest rates. Sound familiar? We'd just seen the fall of the Berlin Wall and the opening up of Europe and the shocking events in Tiananmen Square. As I gained my PhD, we were coming to the end of a long-standing government and anticipating just the possibility of something new. And the world I look at today sees echoes of these same events and the newly emerging issues of popularism, the climate crisis, and AI. And yes, I see challenges, but I also see opportunities. The opportunities for your leadership and for the world to be shaped by you. You are the generation that grew up online and lived through a pandemic. You are all familiar with that world that for many seems so strange and new. And you have the ability to see what can be, to look at the challenges in the world and find solutions. And now is the time to take a few moments to reflect on your achievements and look forward to the future, whatever it may hold, and to hold on to those opportunities. I think that the adversity that our graduates have overcome deserves rightful acknowledgement, but your achievements, which we're honouring here today, would not have been possible without the support of your parents, guardians, friends, partners, and family members. And I would also like to extend my thanks to all who have encouraged and supported you during your studies here at Newcastle University. So take a moment to look to your left and your right and look at the people sitting around you. These are the people who have been by your side literally and virtually throughout your time at Newcastle. Together, you have been through the return to campus together and you have made it. Take these memories with you and continue to support each other along the various journeys of your life. For those graduating today, I now invite you to stand, if you can, and show your appreciation for the people who have supported you by a round of applause. Graduates, as you look forward to embarking upon the next chapter of your lives, I just want to take a moment to consider the vital role that you are playing in helping us deliver our vision of Newcastle as a world-leading university, advancing knowledge, providing creative solutions, and solving global problems. As we like to say, from Newcastle for the world. And there are no better exemplars of this ideal than graduates of computing. The sheer breadth of specialisms, from cloud computing, data science, and cybersecurity, to game engineering, human-computer interaction, and bioinformatics at this ceremony, tells us something about how much computing technology touches all of our lives, sometimes in unexpected ways. For example, did you know that the video games engineers from Newcastle are developers for the world's leading game studios? Yes, but also crucially, have been working on games that assist stroke rehabilitation and eye disorder diagnosis. Demand is high and growing for graduates equipped with your skills. You have only to consider the changes to the way we have all worked during the pandemic and afterwards to realise the power of computer science to change the world. Advances in computer science enabled reliable and secure online communication, sharing, analysis, and presentation of large quantities of data, and the investigation and modelling of the pandemic itself. Computing is becoming a much broader subject, enabled by the emergence of revolutionary technologies such as cloud computing, machine learning, and of course, AI. Artificial intelligence is more than ever a hot topic, which brings with it concerns about the power and scope of large language models such as ChatGPT, and their effect not only on the technology sector, but also academia and our everyday lives. Computer scientists have been pioneering research on AI for many years, and subject experts and our graduates are well placed to cut through all the hyperbole and provide a balanced, informed view to make the most of the opportunities offered by the technology. Many of our graduates use their knowledge and skills to find positions in the northeast of England. After all, this is one of the hottest areas for investment in technology and innovation in the UK right now. All sorts of businesses, from small video game engineering houses to startups like app-based challenger banks to global businesses like Sage, Nextcenture, all employ graduates in this region. Others are taking up careers in the world's big name technology companies like Amazon Web Services, IBM, Google, Microsoft, and Apple. Many will put their knowledge and skills to use in other sectors, such as manufacturing, the automotive and aerospace industries, and still others enter sectors that possibly might be a little bit surprising at first, like the growing pharmaceutical and biotechnology industries. You have a wealth of career opportunities at your fingertips. But what is perhaps truly exciting is that many of the careers that you will end up in are in jobs that don't even exist right now. When I graduated, I of course didn't know where I would end up, but the job actually did exist. That is not so for you, and you can't possibly see where you will be in 30 years' time, and that's truly exciting. So don't be afraid to use your knowledge and skills to lead and drive the change that we all need to adapt our ways of living, improve our health, protect our environment, and save our planet. The range of topics that you have covered in your studies, along with your problem solving and analytical skills, will help you change these critical challenges. I have no doubt that some of you will be part of a future in which AI is seen as a gift and not a curse. And equally, don't be afraid to sometimes go against the grain, especially if it's something that you feel really passionate about, even if it might make you unpopular for a while. Choose a career which will both challenge and satisfy you and enables you to be the best that you can be, where you feel appreciated, rewarded, and can make a positive difference. And my favourite, remember that no one ever reaches their full potential by staying in their comfort zone. So challenge yourself, embrace the journey, and take it all in your stride. And don't forget, as a Newcastle University graduate, you are now part of a constantly growing global community of fellow alumni, which this winter will exceed over 250,000 members. The network is here to support and inspire you, both professionally and socially, wherever you are in the world. So make the most of it, stay in touch, and you're always welcome back to inspire others with your achievements. On behalf of everyone at Newcastle University, congratulations, graduates of 2023. You are our greatest achievement, and I wish you all the success, happiness, and fulfillment you deserve for the exciting future ahead. And today marks the beginning of your bright new future. Congratulations.
Professor Glendinning, I certify that the candidates to be presented at this congregation have satisfied all the requirements of the university. Professor Glendinning, the head of the School of Computing prays leave to present candidates who are qualified to proceed to awards in the School of Computing.
Professor Morgan.
Professor Glendinning, I present to you candidates to be admitted to awards in the School of Computing.
By the authority of the university, I admit these candidates to the awards for which they are now qualified.
The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Bioinformatics. Ksenia Asifenshu. Rohan Joseph Bessie. Oliver Francis Eardley Gutteridge. Billy Smith. Jason Han Kiat Tham. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Cloud Computing. Sonali Ravindra Bartal. Zuan Chen. Ramesh Krishna Chanajurai. Andreas Gekopoulos. Shuja Masool. Antrias Panagiotou. Marios Pelikanos. Sajiv Rednama. Sonam Singh. Ray Ray Zhao. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Computer Game Engineering. Daniel Thomas Abraham. Ashwin Shrikant Banwa. Cho Hin Chow. Max Elliott. Ryan David Holt. Jamil Islam. Shah Shuut K. Sayob. Emun Khan. Alex Knight. Ziyang Li. Zai Yang Liu. Simone Noble. Rishpa Sivagranathan. Kane Sung. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Cybersecurity: Wad Nasir Akwatani. Nabil Al-Zobay. Endrance Noma Asawata. Savas Katimiris. Swathi Lakshmanarayan. Xiao Hao Li. Safura Muhammad Arif. Segayuki Oki. Andreas Sergey. Yu Chao Zhang. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Data Science: Jashwant Anandan. Prithvish Atru Prakash. Teresa Banning. Jake Bonici. Yash Shudhir Borikal. Pratamesh Prasant Chavan. Sidesh Shashikant Demal. Joyce Moto Gita. Gokul Gopakuma Srikala. Sabrina Hossain. Kui Lin Anlis Hao Chiapakin. Chadna Jayanthi Satheath. Mamtha. Nagar Prasad Kanchi. Sivamurugan Krish Nepapadiyan. Rohit Kumar. Karan Kumawat. Rishab Malik. Akash Mohandas. Shonak Moharari. Maheshwara Ro Mukha. Daraksha Fatma Naqvi. Vishal Vijay Pawar. Pradeep Pradeep. Akhil Raj Rajan. Gautam Ramesh. Jugdish Ravichandran. Hannah Suter. Shweta Suresh Kumar. Louisa Waring. Yu Meng Wei. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Data Science with specialism in Artificial Intelligence. Ayman Ahmed. Nakshatra Kumar Belung. Manish Bhardwaj. Richard Patrick Karasala Joe Dominic. Anusha Chike Gowda. Morgan Claire McMurtry Frodsham. Amila Goering. Joyce Jason. Sabing Jung. Ishani Deepak Kulkarni. Gautam Sai Tijaluka. Kieran McAdoo. Gabriel Medina Galicia. Hemika Mishra. Salah Mohammed Ali. Arushi Natiyal. Vinit Ball. Subham Kumar Singh. AJ Richardson Sura. Samuel Smith. Georgina Harriet Talukdar. Ashwin Kumar Uniyal. Tanvi Vishwanath Wagle. Jordan Thomas Wilson. Panida Riri Yachapon. Harry James Oliver Wright. Lai Chen Yang. The following graduate is presented for the degree of Master of Science in Data Science with specialism in visualization. Spruha Mohunti. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Digital and Technology Solutions, Specialist Integrated Degree Apprenticeship, Data Analytics Specialist. Anthony Philip Austin. Peter Behan. Gabriella Lydia Debretsny. Ian Donaldson. Simon Holland. James Nicholson. Selena Y. Manso. Ben Ward. Callum James Wilson. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Human Computer Interaction. Aliza Lim Lee Fuong. Helen Jaelan Akgul. Mohammed Ali. Javeria Anjum. Michael Harry Balfour. Yorgos Christodoulou. Ankush Dogra. Megalika Peter Zosa. Amal Gell. Marta Grabowski. Lucia Ayoano. Shaktival Jambuval. Sutakon Khan Panichko. Ming Hong Lee. Win Si Liu Ling. Sarah Michelle Rumapia. Nanjundayai Sean Shonapanahali. Deeksha Sharma. William Randolph Sizer. Cameron Taylor. Chongcheng Chang. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Master of Science in Synthetic Biology. Connor Brownson. Remy Edgar Goitia Camacho. Munirat Ukunlola Munia. The following graduates are presented for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. For research in methods to manage and analyze large amounts of data generated by IoT and social media for early warning systems and smart city applications. Nipun Balan Thekakumar. for research in synthetic biology and mathematical modeling, Louis John Grosinger. For research in computer science education, Laura Elizabeth Heels. For research in developing trustworthy data-driven approaches for analyzing and designing safety-critical systems, Milad Kazima Mehrabadi. For research in optimizing rescaling operations of streaming applications, Paul Osagi Omaregabi. For research in formal methods from computer science, control theory, and power system engineering, Ben Wooding. At this point in the ceremony, we would like to draw your attention to the list of graduates who have been awarded academic prizes. The list can be found at the center of the congregation brochure. Please join me in giving these graduates a warm round of applause. Before the proceedings are brought to a close, I'm delighted to introduce our student orator, Sahia Mohammed Ali, who graduated with the degree of Master of Science in Data Science with specialism in Artificial Intelligence. Sahia will address the congregation on behalf of the students we are celebrating here today.
Graduates, faculty members, and esteemed guests. It's a great honor to deliver this address, and I express my sincere gratitude for entrusting me with this responsibility. Today marks as the culmination of an incredible journey, filled with hard work, dedication, and growth. The nice piece of paper which we have received today represents not only the academic growth and knowledge we have gained, but also of our personal growth and resilience. This paper reminds us of our countless efforts, challenges, and triumphs that have shaped us into the individuals we are today. Let's take a moment to reflect on the countless hours we have spent during lectures, lab sessions, and late nights at library in pursuit of knowledge. We have dived into the breadth and depth of our course modules, analyzing, coding, debugging, and troubleshooting until early hours. The library became a hub of focused energy as we delved into textbooks, research papers, exchanged ideas, and collaborated on projects that shaped our academic journey. Those late night hard works were not just about meeting deadlines. It was about our dedication and determination, where we discovered the depths of our capabilities. Together, we have weathered the storms of deadlines, celebrated large and small victories, formed bonds that endure beyond the confines of these academic walls. The memories we have created, the lessons we have learned from one another, and the camaraderie that we have shared had made this experience truly remarkable. It will be imprinted forever in our memories as a symbol of perseverance, determination, and collective efforts. Let's take a moment to reflect and appreciate the determination that carried us through those long nights. The resilience that extends beyond the coursework that will undoubtedly serve us in the face of future challenges. May the lessons learned during the course serve as a foundation for the bright future that awaits each one of us. Our professors, mentors, and the entire university community has been the guiding light on this academic journey. The time they have spent imparting knowledge, the patience with which they have answered our queries, the guidance they have provided during the lab sessions, all have left an indelible impact and mark on our academic journey. They have not only imparted knowledge, but also instilled in us a hunger for continuous learning and a passion for excellence. From the bottom of my heart, I extend my gratitude for the unwavering support of Newcastle University, the dedicated faculty and staff in guiding us with knowledge and expertise. I'm thankful to our families and friends for being the pillars and supporting us during our academic journey. Thank you so much for believing in our potential, even during the moments we doubted ourselves. Your encouragement propelled us to move forward. Your seen and unseen sacrifices have paved the way for our academic success. Thank you so much for your immeasurable influence. As we embark on our respective paths, let us continue to uphold the values of integrity, perseverance, and compassion that have been ingrained in us during our time here. And may this fuel our passion and drive us towards a future filled with endless opportunities. Let us strive to make a best and positive impact on our communities and beyond. Use our collective efforts to shape a brighter and more promising future for the generations to come. Thank you, and wishing you all the best for your future.
Will you please stand?
This congregation is now dissolved.
Thank you.
We hope you've enjoyed the ceremony and have some memorable moments to take away with you today. In a moment, we will ask the graduates to process out of the north door behind me and into the courtyard. Could we please ask that you make your way through the arch into the student forum to enable your guests to leave the hall quickly? Please then make your way straight to the reception in the Lindisfarne room in the Hadrian building. Graduates, please keep a hold of your tickets so you can exchange it for a small graduation gift at the reception. As the graduates are leaving, I would just like to ask everybody just to give one last round of applause as they all leave the hall. Thank you.